Succumbed to nuclear radiation from the pale skin and the bald head. It doesn't work for me. So we'll go with Lex Luthor. That's fine. But it sucks being pale. I mean, this is the one month of the year where I know what racism is like. Because everyone's up. No. So I know what racism is like because they walk up, they're like, oh, you must be getting excited. St. Patty's Day is coming up. I'm not Irish at all. My last name's McMillan, yes, that's Scottish, first of all, to get your mix straight. And then second of all, just because I'm pale and blue-eyed and I get blackout drunk doesn't mean I'm Irish. That's all that means. But, whatever, so this is my one month a year where I'm like, I get it, I'm so sorry. But, so I used to work in banking, so I had this suit left over for my new job. And it made me hate people. Because banking is probably one of the worst things you can work with. Besides food, banking is the worst thing you can work with people. Like, when you touch their money, yep. Like, it's the worst thing. Are you a banker? Who said yeah?
Me.
Are you a banker? I don't know where you are. I can't see you. It's okay. I'll just follow the voice. You work in banking?
Yeah.
Sucks, right?
That's horrible.
It's horrible. So, because, like, alright, so people will come into the bank and they'll be like, look, can I have a deposit slip? Or they want to make a deposit. So I'm like, oh, okay. So I give them the slip, and they're like, I don't know how to fill this out. It says name, date, amount, and account number. Like, what? It's not fucking hieroglyphics. It's English. We've all learned this. I mean, what's your name? Like, I'll help you with this. Do you know today's date? Do you know where you are? I'm not even asking for your social. Like, just... It's like they look at it and they're like, I don't know what to do with this. God. And then I love the people when they're like, they don't get their way. I'm gonna blast you on social media. Fucking tell on me? You're gonna tell on me. That's basically what you're saying. You're an adult and you're gonna tell on me. So here's what I'm gonna do. And I feel like this is the only way to do it. Next time they're gonna say that, I'm gonna be like, if you do that, I'm gonna come to your next family party and tell them all what a piece of shit you are. Because that's basically what you're doing to me. So stop. Stop your shit. Grow up. And the things that people say to you. Like, one thing I hate with banking, people just come in every day and they thought they were clever. And of course now, because I'm in stand-up comedy, I'm like, I'm funnier than you, so shut up. But they come in and they'd be like, I'd be like, oh, how can I help you? You have the winning lottery numbers? I'd be like, no, like five people before you said that. Stop. And then they just say the weirdest things. Like, this lady came in one time and I was helping her. I was like, oh, well, we could do both of these things right now. She's like, yeah, kill two birds with one hand. And I was like, what the fuck? What? Kill them with one hand? And she's like, yeah, that's how, you know, the saying. I was like, that's not what the saying is. And she's like, well, I don't know. I was like, when in Greece? And she's like, that's not how the saying goes. I was like, well, that's what you just did. I was like, why is it okay when you do it? But it's not okay when I do it. If you want to make up your own sayings, I'm going to do the same thing. Asshole. But I do have a new job now. So now I work for a furniture company. And when they interviewed me, they said, you know, these people get crazy. I'm like, listen, I worked with banking. I worked at Wegmans, I worked with food, like, I get it, like, it's fine. They're like, no, you don't know. I'm like, no, I know. I didn't know. I didn't know. If someone doesn't get their love seat, holy shit, they lose their mind. And they're like, I'm like, you know, I apologize for the inconvenience. And they're like, you don't mean that. And honestly, I'm just like, you're right, I don't fucking mean that. You're an asshole. Oh my god, what the hell's wrong with you? You didn't get your chair, calm down, sit on the floor for a little bit. Go for a walk. Jesus. But anyway, so I started this new job, and You ever have an awkward handshake?
Yeah.
It's horrible. So one day they told me that when the CEO comes in, I won't know who he is because he doesn't like dress up fancy or anything. He just kind of comes in with a t-shirt on, a backpack, and you won't even know. So I'm sitting there and I'm on the phone with someone and he reaches out his hand and I gave him the wrong hand. I did one of these. I gave him like the little this handshake. And I was like, all right, I'm going to get fired. And the next time he came over to me, he went to go give me a pound, so I like punched his hand. He was like, what the hell was that? I was like, I was trying to make up, I don't know if you remember. And he's like, oh, no, I remember. He's like, this. He's like, give me a lobster claw. That's what you're writing. Give me a pansy-ass lobster claw. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. But last time I was here, before I came here, I met Geraldo Rivera. And I made a joke about it, and I think my joke actually led. Does anyone watch Dancing with the Stars?
Oh,
yeah. All the women? I think I'm responsible for Geraldo being on Dancing with the Stars this season. Because when I met him, I was like, you're Geraldo Rivera. And he's like, I didn't think someone your age would know who I was. And I did point out to him that his jacket said Geraldo. Much help. But I think because of that meeting he was inspired. He's like, I gotta get in touch with the youth of America. So now he's on Dancing with the Stars. So I take credit for that. It's not. I just said, yeah, I mean, wait till you watch the show and then not applause for that. But like, some of these reality shows are so stupid. Like my mom's watching Say Yes to the Dress. I heard chains rattling. Like someone's clapping but not really hitting their hand. Say Yes to the Dress is so stupid. It's so dumb. Like I feel like if there was like a male version of it, it'd be just say yes to anything and let's get the fuck out of it. Put that. That's gonna be on Spike TV. Keep that for Bravo and. You know. But yeah, those things are just so stupid. But anyway, so I wanted to talk about how awkward I am. I know I look so suave right now, but don't let it deceive you. This pale boy is not suave at all. I have this pickup line that I think works, it doesn't. But I used to live in Brooklyn, and there's a place called Puppet Works near me. It's in Park Slope, really cool, they do puppet shows. And for some reason in my head, I was like, that's like the coolest thing ever. So I started asking girls, like, you want to go see a puppet show? They looked at me like that I was going to skin them with a vegetable and make a suit out of them. It doesn't, so don't ever do that. And then, I'm not going to dirty talk. Not going to dirty talk at all. She's like, you know, talk about dirty to me. Come on, let's get wild. I was like, all right. So I asked her to call me Willy Wonka. And she, it was as awkward as that was right there. She was kind of like, why? It's from the Amtrak bar. You got the golden ticket, girl. Now? But girls, you guys make it hard, though. You guys are like, I always meet girls that are like, you can't handle me. I probably can't. You're right. And girls are always like, yeah, I'm not like other girls. Stop. Please, girls, if you ever don't. Have any of you ever said I'm not like other girls? Thank you for being honest. Thank you. Because that's bullshit. Because at this point, there's no girl that's not like other girls. Because honestly, you couldn't even surprise me if you had a penis under your skirt. At this point. You got Caitlyn Jenner running around, but you're not going to surprise me. Just, oh, alright, whatever. That's what you got. Good for you. So, Donald Trump. Here's my thing on Donald Trump. I hate him. But I feel like this is just to simplify, I feel like when you vote for Donald Trump, remember when you were in school and you had to vote for the class president to represent you, you know? Everyone usually, I ran for it, but I was the class clown. I knew I wasn't going to do shit. I was the guy that was up there. I was like, we're not going to have to come to school except for on Monday, Tuesday and Friday, we're off. Free lunch, and we're only gonna come to school three days a year. That's it. And they're like, "Trump's funny. Vote for him." I'm like, I stick my finger through my fly. Vote for him. Donald Trump. So you're voting for the guy who sticks his finger through his thigh rather than the Asian kid in the back who really could make a difference and get 30 cents off your milk carton. And you shouldn't do that. That's not what America needs. Jesus. But, and then I just saw recently, I went under my dad's bed, and Playboy got rid of nudity. Once I went under my dad's bed, I was like, what the hell is this? Come under here to get an encyclopedia? I mean, I'm 30, but still, that's weird enough. But, I mean, why are they're like, well, people focus more on the articles. When I was 14 or 15, I was like, hey guys, you want to go read about socialism? See what's on the dad's bed. No. No, that's not what we want. We just want to, you know. And then, 50 Shades of Grey. Everyone like 50 Shades of Grey?
Yeah.
Of course, the women.
Yeah.
And I just want to say, like, I feel like it took you guys so long to catch up and be like, oh my god, there's so much crazy things out there, like handcuffs and spanking. Oh my god. Go on your boyfriend's browser history. Go on your brother's browser history. Go on your father's browser history. I don't want to move out. It's disgusting what we look at. To me, that's Sesame Street. You guys are having like that Ariel Little Mermaid moment, like, a whole new world. I'm like, what? I'm like, no, this is like C is for cookie, cookie is for me. Stop your shit. And that's all I got. But thank you guys so much for that.